I'm really excited for today and the life of not just this ministry, but in the life of all of us, because you know, as we have been sharing over the past, you know, I guess this year and even last year, how God, as God's people, you know, we really have a unique and an awesome, we're really in a unique and an awesome position, because He speaks to us in ways that sometimes seem unconventional, but are nevertheless ways that are powerful and impactful, and that really set our lives on a course that we can be really, really significant and powerful ambassadors for Him and for His cause. And so, you know, really today is just proof positive that God is still in the business of doing that. I'm excited today for our guest speaker, who I promised last week. I'm excited because of how the Lord is working in his life.
Praise the Lord.
I'm excited for how God is using him, even as he is right now, even where he is right now. We know that where he is right now is not all that God has in store for him. And so whenever you see that, I mean, I just really get excited when I see God moving in the life of his people and people responding to what God is doing in their life. And so, you know, I'm going to certainly get out of the way, but we all know Brother Lorenzo as one of our young people who serves. You know, I was going to call him Trace, you know, but at a certain point, I don't know about you, at a certain point, I'm just like, I mean, he's just Lorenzo. I'm excited about what God is doing in his life. And so a couple of weeks ago, he actually asked me whether or not I would be willing to allow him to speak.
Amen.
And that's really different, and that's really powerful, because sometimes pastors, we've got to go seeking people and asking people, hey, will you speak, or will you speak? And so it's really a blessing when people come and say, hey, would you mind if I speak? And I'm, you know, I'm like, absolutely. And so that really blessed my heart, and really served as an encouragement for me, because it really lets me know that God is speaking to him and speaking to his heart and working in his life, as he's working in all of our lives. Yes. But when we reach the point to where we know it's God, and we know that it's God, to the point to where we just can't keep it to ourselves, and we want to share it with somebody else, what God is doing, that's really, really powerful. And so I'm excited today for just this opportunity to hear from him. We've all been around him. We know that he's a young man who's very, very mature beyond his years. And we know and have sort of watched him grow up. And I know Angela and I had a front row seat and as he was one of the finest ring bearers the world has ever known. Some 21 years ago. Amen. It's just amazing to see how the Lord has brought him up through high school and, you know, all the way through college, a man of integrity, a man of intelligence, a man of wisdom, even at his young age, to be so rooted and grounded in what is right. And so we certainly owe that a lot to his mother and his father, who brought him up in the fear and admonition of the Lord. But above all things, we owe all praise and honor to God, for it is God that is owed all of the glory. For we know, and we look around on the news, and we often see young men, particularly young African-American men, who oftentimes get sidetracked and go astray. But it's just really so good to be in the presence of a young man who has stayed the course, and a young man who has done it the right way.
Praise the Lord.
And we know that God is going to honor his obedience. We know that God is going to honor his sacrifice. And so I just thank him, for availing himself to be used by God on this morning at this particular time, in this particular season. And we know that what God is doing in his life, it is not just to benefit him, but it is also to benefit those whom he comes in contact with.
That's right.
And so we consider it a high honor and just a wonderful thing that God has blessed us and allowed us to be here on this morning as he speaks through his vessel of honor this morning. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So at this time, without further ado, I'm going to introduce Lorenzo Waters III. Amen. Hear ye him and be blessed.
Good
morning,
church.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
you don't mind, we have a word of prayer.
Amen.
Just to start it off, keep our heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for bringing us here together,
yes,
and for organizing this and making the provisions, Lord, for all of us to be here at this exact moment, Lord. It is not by fault or by accident that we're all here on this morning, able to receive your word. Please use me as your vessel in order to tell the people about who you are and what you've done in my life, and able to do in their lives as well, Lord. Amen. Please open the ears of your people, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And bless their hearts, speak to their spirit, Lord. And I pray these blessings. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you will stand with me, our scripture reading for today, we have Proverbs 16, verses 1 through 9, and also Romans 8, verses 5 through 8. We're going to read from Proverbs 16, 1 through 9 first. Standing, you stop moving, I'm assuming this you already got. That's good. All right, Proverbs 16, 1 through 9. It says, to humans belong the plans of the heart, but from the Lord comes the proper answer of the tongue. All a person's ways seem pure to them, but motives are weighed by the Lord. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans. The Lord works out everything to his proper end. Even the wicked for a day of disaster. The Lord detests all the proud of heart. Be sure of this, they will not go unpunished. Through love and faithfulness, sin is atoned for. Through the fear of the Lord, evil is avoided. When the Lord takes pleasure in anyone's way, he causes their enemies to make peace with them. Better a little with righteousness than much gain with injustice. In their hearts, humans plan their course. But the Lord establishes their steps. We turn to Romans chapter 8, verses 5 through 8. Those who live in according to the flesh have their minds set on what the flesh desires. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their minds set on what the Spirit desires. The mind governed by the flesh is death. But the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. The mind governed by the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God.
Amen.
Amen.
Focus scripture for today is what I just read, Romans chapter 8, verses 5 through 8. If you just read along and not comprehend what I'm saying, I'm going to read it again for you, just in case. chapter 8, verse 5 goes, it says, those who live in accordance to the flesh have their mind set on what the flesh desires. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their mind set on what the Spirit desires. The mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. The mind governed by the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And today's scripture title will be called God Bubble. You may have your seats. Okay. Before we start, I just want to look to you. Have you looked to your neighbor? Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
I'm not sure what he's going to say. But I know it's from the Lord. Amen. So I just want you to just to kind of be relaxed, because I'm gonna talk to you, because you know I'm a pretty frank person. I'm not gonna try to preach to you, I'm going to try to bring you in, because you know I feel like you guys are my brothers and sisters in Christ.
Amen.
Okay.
So I want you to think, how many people can attest to being able to look back on their life and thinking, this is the best situation I could possibly be in? You know, you can raise your hand. If you don't feel that way, I don't want you to. You know, I'm gonna be genuine with you. Because honestly, about a week or two ago, my hand would be down as well. So, you know, I'm gonna tell you why. Why would my hand be down? Because I felt betrayed. I felt hurt, anger, I felt depressed, made a mockery of, and simply turned off by God. And it's funny, because Sierra will hear me say this all the time, say, I'm not supposed to be here. I told myself I'd never work a 9-to-5. It was funny, I was sitting with one of my old teammates. He said, you don't work a 9-to-5. You work midnight to 8. so down, I actually caught myself going through some of my old tweets. Now, I'm never on Twitter. I've had my Twitter for about 10 years. I only have about 1,200 tweets. And according to Twitter, that's not a lot of tweets at all. So I caught myself going back through my Twitter because I used to post little motivational messages here and there, you know. Like, all right, maybe I leave an Easter egg I can go back to and, you know, pick myself up from something I said. And it's kind of funny because one of the ones that resonated with me the most, it said, please stop feeling sorry for yourself. Mm-hmm. You wouldn't know a blessing if it smacked you in the face. That was on March 21st, 2013. You know, and after reading that wasn't enough, I continued to scroll, and I came across a few more motivational tweets. And I put that in post because that kind of hurt my feelings. And I posted which said, focus on what I have told you, not what you don't know. That was on October 13, 2013. And I recognized that while I might have posted these things and I've said these things in a different context possibly, mm-hmm. I know that there was a reason why I even posted them in the first place. I don't have any followers on Twitter, but it was a reason why I put it on there. And I'm like, why did I even go on my Twitter today? It did not help me feel any better about myself. It just pretty much told me to suck it up and stop crying. And you know, I mentioned these things to say this. There are no accidents.
That's right.
Or coincidences. Mm-hmm. Because we serve a purpose with God.
That's right.
And if I need to, I'll refer back to today's scripture already because I want you to know that I didn't just make this up. Proverbs 16, verse 9. In their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps.
That's right.
No, in other words, my heart was in one place. But the Lord established my steps.
Praise the Lord.
That really spoke to me. And from me saying things like, I'm not supposed to be here, I'm not supposed to work a 9-to-5, that only took me further and further and further away from where I was really supposed to be. And you know, once again, in case you weren't reading along, when I went through the verse of the day, I got it right here. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 4. It says, the Lord works out everything to its proper end.
That's right.
Even the wicked for a day of disaster. Mm-hmm. And I'm thinking, I'm like, the wicked? You telling me you organized the bombing in Massachusetts and this and that, 9/11? Mm-hmm. And you don't really think about things like that. I don't think about, you know, the Lord being involved with that. But I remember a sermon Pastor Emeritus gave. I believe it was called The Dark Side of Justice, and that really spoke to me. In short, even your bad days, your worst day, the most tragic events, could be a death, anything, the most disheartening things that could possibly happen in your life are accounted for. Mm-hmm. And they are made to its proper end. Right?
Yes.
And these past 2 weeks have been mind-blowing for me. And I'm going to let you in on a little story. If you can bear with me.
All right.
So, just a quick recap. I gave a testimony a couple weeks ago. It's pretty heartfelt. I don't know who might have been here, who not, but I'm gonna give a little recap. So, just a brief story. So, on myself, because I'm not gonna assume that everybody knows me. A lot of you guys just know church me. You don't know. You know, road rage me or 2K, me when I play 2K, or, you know, me on the football field or coaching me, or, you know, long day me or me at work or anything like that. So I'm going to let you in on a little bit about who I am. So, long story short, this is going to be the short story. Long story short, I'm going to fast forward to me going to college. I played college football, started for 3 years at Brooklyn University. It's a major D1 school. I mean, it's not like Florida State or anything like that, but we're good, you know, respectable football. Cool. So I thought I was a big deal. You know, I started for 3 years. You know, I played with guys who were in the league. You know, I got the good grades. You know, I got this, I got that going for me. Mm-hmm. I did everything I was supposed to do. Mm-hmm. And you know, I worked hard. You know, all the things. know, I was pretty much king of the castle. I was king, captain, cool. Because my goal was the NFL.
Right.
All right. So, fast forward, the draft comes. I didn't get drafted. Mm-hmm. Boom. But it's okay. You know, people can sign after the draft.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't get signed up for the draft. So, fast forwarding, I get a minicamp invite. And, you know, a lot of times with the minicamp invites, okay, they'll bring you in, they just want to see you move around a little bit, then they'll give you a contract.
Mm-hmm.
That fell through. I'm like, man, now what? So I'm drowning. I feel like I'm drowning, my head's above water. I come ahead, I cry my little heart out, talking about, you know, woe is me.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Now it's life.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's life. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you go to school, you get a degree, everybody's saying, oh, you got a degree. You don't have any student loans. You know, you got a good family. You're smart. You get a job. Don't worry about it. Came out. Hard to get a job.
Mm-hmm.
Even with everybody got a degree.
Mm-hmm.
What did you experience?
Mm-hmm.
What can you do besides play football?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, these were the tough questions I had to ask myself. You know, who am I?
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't even start with what I'm going to do. You know, I had to start with who am I?
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, beyond that, I really had no purpose. And my big thing is purpose. I need things to make sense. I need purpose in my life.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And without football, you know, I felt like I didn't have a purpose.
Mm-hmm.
So, a guy reached out to me, an old coach who coached me at my high school. He said, we have a new league starting in the spring. I'd like you to come out. It's a developmental league. So basically, you play in this league, you do well, you go to the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, great. This is great news.
Mm-hmm.
Great news. I'm going to train, you know, yada, yada, yada. I'm a coach at my little high school because I don't have anything else to do. All I do is football, so I'm a coach.
Mm-hmm.
And meanwhile, I'm going to try and get ready for this league in the spring. I'm coaching, not making any money. Mm-hmm. You know, high school coaching is just a stipend. You only get, you know, dimes and nickels.
Mm-hmm.
It's cool. But one of the coaches on the staff said, anybody looking to make some money? yeah. I can't even get to practice. I don't have any gas money. I need to make some money. All right, follow along. I promise it's not a football story. I'm just disclaiming, it's not a football story. So I go through the training, I get a job, make an X amount of money, and by X amount of money, it's a big X. I make X amount of money. So I'm happy, I'm good, but I'm not satisfied because my plans was here.
Mm-hmm.
But God's plans were here.
All right,
right.
That's right.
Okay. So the league was coming up. Spring was coming up. I was supposed to leave on April 1st to play in this league. So I took leave from my job. And I took leave with no guarantee that I'd be able to go back.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm going to the league. I'm telling everybody at my job, hey, I got this opportunity. I'm about to play. I'm about to make some dollars.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just hold on. I'm not coming back here. I'm going to see y'all later. You know, next time y'all see me, I'm be driving down Pennsylvania Avenue, you know, and something nice. So April 1st came. I'm waiting for my plane ticket. Nothing.
Mm-hmm.
April 2nd came.
Mm-hmm.
I got an email.
Mm-hmm.
The league has disbanded.
Mm-hmm.
And investor backed out.
Mm-hmm.
We will no longer have a 2016 Major League Football season.
Mm-hmm.
Boom.
Mm-hmm.
Pay attention to the justice, that means.
Mm-hmm.
So now what? I'm embarrassed. I can't go back to my job. I just told him I was going to be, you know, get my babe back. I can't go back there. What am I supposed to do? But I remember an ex-Rutgers football player reached out to me, and he had told me about this pro day. It's a chance to showcase your talents in front of a bunch of NFL scouts. So you do well doing some drills for them, they'll sign you. That's it. And that was on April 7th. So once again, this is not a football story. So essentially, I had 3 days to get ready.
Okay. And these drills they want me to do, this is something that people train for months and months and months, mm-hmm. three times a day. You know, and this is something I had 3 days to get ready for. Mm-hmm. Whatever. I'm just gonna, you know, walk out on a limb. Monday, April 4th. Visited the Rutgers training facility. I met a guy named Julian, walked around with him. Ran into somebody I went to Athletes in Action, which is a an athlete's Bible study that they had. Mm-hmm. And they asked me, are you going to Bible study on Tuesday? I was like, yeah, I might be there, you know, giving them the right answer. Mm-hmm. Ain't no way I'm going to no Bible study. I'm up here for 3 days. I'm not going to spend my time in no Bible study. Cool. So Tuesday I worked out. I'm done at daggone like 1 o'clock. I had nothing to do, so where'd I end up? Right at that daggone Bible study. So it's not the Bible study that spoke to me. It's not the Bible study that spoke to me, but before it starts, you have a bunch of people from the sports teams kind of just telling everybody what's going on, updating them, because there's various sports groups in there. Mm-hmm. Guy from the football team, a freshman, I didn't know who he was, just said that, boom, we're having a scrimmage on Saturday. I was like, ooh, wow, let me put that in my back pocket. I didn't know there was a scrimmage. I might stay up here until Saturday. Mm-hmm. I kind of want to check these guys out. So, fast forwarding, Wednesday work out cool, and then I meet up with another guy named Jawan Wynn. He's my old roommate. And then we went to IHOP, cool. And he was like, oh, you want to go to the movies? I said, all right, what you want to see? You know, Batman, Superman, something. You know, something like a bros would watch. He said, no, man, I want to see Miracles from Heaven. I said, what? What? Miracles from Heaven? I looked on my phone. I was like, man, I don't know about no Miracles from Heaven. You know, and I didn't say yes, but he got me to go in there. And I'm telling you, this movie changed me.
Praise the Lord.
In a way that I would have never expected. It put into perspective so many things about how I used to view the world and how I view it today. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's fast forward a little bit more. I'm going to get back to that. The big day, April 7th, while I'm here. The reason why I came up to Jersey. You know, I met a couple of the coaches, NFL scouts. I actually knew a couple of guys from the 49ers, from the Colts. Boom, I'm like, man, it's a good day. I know him. It's nothing but a high five, and I'm in there. Mm-hmm. I get to my drills, the worst I've ever done in my life. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you, I could have walked a drill better than I could have done it then. The slowest mm-hmm. I ever ran. Mm-hmm. The worst I've ever done in anything that I've ever done. Ever. It was terrible. And it was a point during the actual pro day, I was going to walk out of the facility and drive home. Mm-hmm. It was a point where I put my stuff on.
Wow.
It started walking out of the facility. Mm-hmm. And then someone spoke to me and said, just finish, man. Just finish. That's been my big thing. Just finish. All right, so I go back, finish, didn't get any better. Cool. So I was pretty sad after. I waited around for the weekend. A few old teammates wanted to go out, uh-huh. and I wanted to see the scrimmage. Mm-hmm. Got to the scrimmage, and ran a couple old guys, and everything I came out, I saw some guys aspiring to go to the NFL, you know, training, another guy putting guards, you know, I got big high hopes, you know, I'm supposed to be this, that, and the third. First thing I say to him, what do you think? Man, I don't know, man. It's rough out there. You know, it's hard to get drafted. You know, it's about who you know. I told him, you know, it's a scam. You know, you better make sure you got some experience when you get out there in the job force. You know, it's degrees. Degrees don't mean nothing unless you're being a doctor or a lawyer or, you know, with IT or anything like that. So, you know, I didn't even realize what I was doing to him at the time. But I went on watching the scrimmage, and then there was a guy. His name was Miles Shuler. And he's the reason why I'm up here today. And he definitely changed my life in a way that I'm going to try to explain to you, but it's going to be hard because, you know, some things are beyond explanation.
Yes.
You know, I sat up with him for 2 hours talking to him during the football scrimmage with thousands and thousands of people inside of a little bubble. It's a football bubble, we call it a bubble. It's a football bubble with a football field in it. And, you know, he told me what was known as a God vote. And this is why I'm up here today. So you guys still with me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
With
me. All right.
All right. I said all this for a reason. So I led you through all this, you know, for a reason. So it's funny when I saw him because he was so bad and happy. Like, have you ever looked at somebody and just was like, why are you so happy? Like, why are you smiling? What a scream. No, like, it's not, you know, you didn't make it to the league yet. Like, what do you like? And it kind of make you mad. So, it, you know, you kind of ask questions like, what is it that they have that I don't have, you know? They got some clothes, they got some jade, you know, they got some jewelry, they got a nice little job lined up, you know, backup, fallback job, a new car, a new girlfriend. So, you know, I began to inquire about some of the things that were going on with them, and not necessarily because I cared, just because I'm just curious as to why he's smiling so daggone much. And, you know, I tell him about my pro day, how it didn't go well, and I left a job that paid well, and feel a stranger in Rutgers because they got a new staff, everybody's new, I don't really know anybody anymore. And I was once the king of this place. Mm-hmm. And I felt betrayed by God, what I believed to be his plan. Mm-hmm. And he said, I know exactly what you're going through. And somehow, you know, all these people I was in this facility with just seemed to be background moves and just kind of disappeared. And, you know, with all the whistles clashing, coaches and fans and parents cheering, and, you know, it was all just background noise. Mm-hmm. And he's not any kind of Jesus freak or anything, you know, walking around with a Bible on his back pocket or anything. But you know, no one can tell you, you know what you can do or what you should do when you come into the Lord. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
So I'm going to refer back to our scripture passage, Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans.
Amen.
That's right.
And what he said to me essentially is that I need to reestablish my relationship with God. Mm-hmm. And there are too many people who have an influence on what it is that he's telling me to do. Mm-hmm. And he's already put things in the order for me.
Yes, yes.
You know, and this is kind of how we drew it up. I don't know if you had the board. Yeah. But I kind of want to draw this for you guys so you have a better idea of what I'm talking about. And this is the image that he gave me. And I want to give you guys a visual because this is how it's spoken. So, So what he said was, I need my God vote. So this is him. This is Miles. And he's happy, of course, because I already mentioned that he's happy. And this is his God vote. Boom. This is him. Who God at the top. However you want God to look like. And what happened when I saw him is I felt this aura. Mm-hmm. I felt this aura about him. There was something about him that I knew that I needed. Mm-hmm. I couldn't explain it. Mm-hmm. It wasn't on his person, but I knew that I needed him. Mm-hmm. So say this is me. Now, I knew what he was talking about because I had a relationship with God, but the way he carried himself, I could feel that. Mm-hmm. He was hundreds of feet away, and I saw him. Mm-hmm. I felt him. He saw me. Because he knew I was hurt. Mm-hmm. He knew I had this. But it was closing in on me. It was closing in, getting tighter and tighter until it was about to pop. Mm-hmm. So, I'm going to leave that right there for a second. So, what's significant about this is a lot of times people that try to penetrate your bubble, you know, people poking and prodding from all directions.
Yes.
They're not going to be the drunk on the corner. Mm-hmm. They're not going to be, you know, the hobo walking up to you in Walmart. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They're not going to be, you know, somebody you would never take advice from. It's not going to be them. Mm-hmm. You know who's going to be? Mm-hmm. It's going to get close to home. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, church, because I'm gonna keep it 100, because that's who I am. Mm-hmm. This is who it is. Mm-hmm. And this is how I realized, you know, played a big part in a lot of what was holding me back. Mm-hmm. Not to say that these people, I don't want you to get the wrong message. These people love you more than anybody who could in this world. Mm-hmm. But who's in this bubble right here? Mm-hmm. It's just you. Mm-hmm. Nobody else can hear this voice. This is the right line. Mm-hmm. Nobody else can hear this voice.
That's right.
Amen.
But you.
That's right.
When God's speaking to you, mm-hmm. you're the only one who can hear him.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Nobody else, your family can't tell you what God's saying to you.
That's right.
Amen.
Your best friends can't tell you what God's saying
Amen.
To you. Your church folk can't tell you what God's saying to you.
That's right.
All they see is you.
That's it.
They don't see the bubble you're in. They don't see how big your bubble is. They don't see how big your plan is. They don't see how big the radius is for your blessing.
Mm-hmm.
Your
Amen.
I'm gonna get fancy with all this.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm holding. I'm gonna hold it. I'm gonna make sure I have the visual. So I'm gonna start over. This is gonna get interesting.
All right.
This is what it is. So. You know, the funny thing about it too is just because this person has a bubble with God, and this person has a bubble with God, does not mean that you two bubble will combine.
That's true.
You ever been around church folk? You just been rubbed the absolute wrong way?
Mm-hmm.
You just been like, that's okay. That's okay. It's normal. That happens all the time. I went to a ministry at Rutgers, and I went there one time. I was like, never again. And laying hands on me like I got leprosy. That made me uncomfortable. I was uncomfortable, and you know, I'm not gonna, you know, but some churches, you know, kind of put you through a bubble filter.
Mm-hmm.
So they want everybody's bubble to look the same. You know, who's to say,
Amen.
You know, who's to say that my bubble can't look like this? It's like a factory, like a church factory putting out, you know, the status, like, you know, stock bubbles.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's not how it is. But where we were, where we met on that day, me and my old teammate, Miles, we were here.
Okay.
So just imagine, because we worship the same God,
mm-hmm.
just imagine how powerful this connection is right here.
Mm-hmm.
Just imagine how much you can do. We got these things flowing. It don't even matter which way it goes, because it's all getting through.
Mm-hmm.
So I felt,
it's okay.
And because I felt him on this day, you know where I am today? Church. I'm here behind this pulpit.
Metaphorically. Praise the Lord. Right.
So just imagine. You know, we weren't even talking about anything.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't talking about, you know, according to this passage, this scripture, this verse, yada, yada, yada. We weren't talking about doctrine.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't talking about, you know, is this real? Because, you know, according to digging up stuff, Dead Sea Scrolls, the Dead Sea Scrolls say this, but, you know, I read something older that meant this, and, you know, that stuff is so true. And I'm telling you that the truth is in you.
Mm-hmm.
The truth is in me right now.
Yes.
This isn't me speaking. This is God speaking
through
me.
Praise the Lord.
And he said the same thing to me. I was like, you're right. Mm-hmm. It was no question. Mm-hmm. You know the truth.
Yes. Yeah.
There's nothing about, you know, if somebody has to convince you of something related to God, it's probably not true. Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's true.
As soon as you see God, you know God.
Yes.
Amen.
That's right.
As soon as you see it, you know it. Yeah. As soon as I saw Miles, boom, I know that's God.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
I might have been able to identify, mm-hmm. you know, what it was about him. Mm-hmm. But after he spoke, mm-hmm. I said, he knows God. Mm-hmm. He has some kind of relationship with God that makes him invincible mm-hmm. in a way. Mm-hmm. And I wanted it.
Right.
Not only did I want it, I needed it. Mm-hmm. But he told me, you know, I was kind of skeptical. I'm not going to just say I jumped out on the limb, but you know, I think, like, man, it's so crazy that, you know, I'm even here today. It's so crazy that, you know, we met up in this bubble. It's so crazy how I ended up. Mm-hmm. He said, stop right there. Why are you saying it's crazy? Mm-hmm. This is normal. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
These people say it's crazy. What's different about them?
Mm-hmm.
They have no bubble. Mm-hmm. These are the ones who see coincidence. Mm-hmm. These are the ones, put a smile back, who see God. Mm-hmm. Nah, it's getting crazy. Where they see coincidence, where they see rest, you see God.
Mm-hmm.
You have trust. You're protected by this bubble.
That's right.
Anything that transpires within this and within your life, you're protected.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you can actually put this board back. I'm not gonna go up behind the board. So, what I hadn't realized the whole time was that I have been protected by this bubble the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the relationship I was able to have with God yes. that had been weakened, but I knew he was still a part of my life.
Yes.
And you know, I'm gonna recap because I think you guys missed some things. I'm gonna say you missed some things because we all missed some things. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to tell that story again briefly, and I want you guys to just think about all the ways that God touched me throughout this short story, mm-hmm. like either before. So, and I want you to really, I'm going to look up whenever something, you know, that God happens, so you know it was God, it wasn't by chance.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to tell the story again. So, I'm going to think how back I'm going to start from. So I was contacted by an older Mantha coach who told me about an opportunity to play in a new league. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He said, you know, things just sounded very cool. I coached for the Mantha, a guy, you know, asked if anybody needs a job, making X amount of dollars a month. So, you know, I didn't know if I was going to be able to return. League, you know, folded, lost about my opportunity. My league got approved. Mm-hmm. Investor backed out, too embarrassed to go back to my job. An ex-Rutgers football player messaged me on Facebook telling me about a pro day at a training facility near Rutgers University. Mm-hmm. 3 days to get ready, yada, yada, yada. Monday, visit the facility, met a person from Athletes in Action. Mm-hmm. Tuesday worked out, so boy, decided to go to the Bible study. And Bible study, a freshman football player told me about a scrimmage that was happening Saturday. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Wednesday, met up with my old team at Juwan, suggested we go see what we call Miracles from Heaven. We changed my life. Big day, April 7th. Met a few scouts who I knew personally from the 49ers and the Colts. Mm-hmm. It was really bad. Wanted to go home, waited around, wanted to see the scrimmage Saturday. Went to old scrimmage, yada, yada, yada. I was a bad influence on a guy that ran to a guy named Nashua. Ran to him, found out about the God bubble, and look where I stand right now. So in this movie, what they did was something similar. I don't want to tell you too much about it because you might actually go see it now. You know, they went through with this girl who had this illness. They took her through the whole movie, and she met people along the way, and eventually, you know, she was able to get it cured. That's not a big surprise because the movie's called Miracles from Heaven, so you know something special happens. Mm-hmm. And then after the movie's over, they kind of recap all the people that she met along the way. Mm-hmm. If she met this person, who met this person, talked to this person, or this person, and she was able to go here because of this, and then, and I realized in my life how often that happens. Mm-hmm. And you know, for you to sit here, I'm not, you know, saying that you should or should not, but it's really hard to raise your hand thinking that you're in the best possible position that you can be in when you don't really even know what it took for you to be in this position. Mm-hmm. Like, how many people really sit down and meditate as to what had to transpire? Mm-hmm. Not just the good things, mm-hmm. but the bad things. Mm-hmm. What had to transpire for you to be here to today?
Yes.
If I were in the NFL, I wouldn't be here today.
That's right. That's right.
If I, you know, if the league hadn't disbanded, I wouldn't be here today. Mm-hmm. You know, if, you know, shoot, I could go anywhere in this thing, you know. If I were to leave after I had a good pro day with all the Rutgers, I wouldn't be here today because, I mean, who's this? I could, could not, you know. Mm-hmm. But I know that things had to happen the way they did. For you and I to be exactly where we are right now.
Yes.
That's right. And I think that's very important. Mm-hmm. And I just want to leave with you guys today that, you know, despite where you see yourself, mm-hmm. and where you ultimately want to be, mm-hmm. things have already been set in order.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Because we serve a purposeful God.
That's right.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And everything that happens is because it's already been put in order.
Amen.
So the times that you feel like you've been betrayed, mm-hmm. let down, mm-hmm. set aside, mm-hmm. put in God's back pocket, you know, forgotten about, mm-hmm. you know, just feeling really small, mm-hmm. you've never been forgotten.
Amen.
You know, right. there's a plan for you.
Amen. Yes.
And it starts with your relationship with God.
That's right.
Amen.
And through this relationship, you have to be able to take that step.
Right.
You have to be able to take the lead, not knowing you're gonna come back. You have to be able to, you know, maybe try out for a team that there's no guarantee. You have to be able to, you know, 3 days of training. You have to see what you can do.
That's right.
You know, might as well just stay around and, you know, have that conversation. And, mm-hmm. and those are just small examples. Mm-hmm. But I know you and guys, you know, you guys have all taken leaps of faith.
Mm-hmm.
And to some, you know, it looks risky. Mm-hmm. To some, it doesn't make sense. Mm-hmm. Why would you leave a job that pays big X amount of dollars, mm-hmm. when you might not be able to get back, and you, mm-hmm. still don't have experience?
Mm-hmm.
That looks crazy. Mm-hmm. To those who don't have the bubble.
That's right.
It looks crazy to those who don't have that pipeline.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right.
That's right.
It looks crazy.
Yes.
It doesn't make sense.
That's right.
And it's not supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Mm-hmm. It's not supposed to.
Praise God.
And that's okay.
That's right.
I don't need it to make sense.
Mm-hmm.
Not for those who aren't in the boat. Not for those who don't understand.
Right.
For those who are questioning you about something that you're doing, mm-hmm. they don't have it.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
They don't.
Amen.
But that's why you do it.
Mm-hmm.
They might see you do this. Man, you got so lucky. Stop right there.
Mm-hmm.
What you mean, luck?
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't nothing but, you know, taking a couple steps.
Mm-hmm.
To me, going to Jersey wasn't nothing but a car ride.
Mm-hmm.
Technically, it wasn't nothing but writing a sheet of paper down.
Mm-hmm.
There were so many other things that happened, but, you know, just for time's sake, I couldn't even mention them. But I just want to keep you guys encouraged today,
mm-hmm.
to not be discouraged.
Right.
Right.
From whatever happens.
That's right.
Because with that relationship with God, you're safe.
Praise the Lord.
And you will step out.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll be all right.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Amen. That's right.
I'm going to leave you guys with that today. Bow your heads.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Dear Lord, thank you for today.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for blessing us.
Yes, Jesus.
Thank you for using me to be in the position that I am today, Lord.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for all that you've done and all who you are, Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
Please continue to allow us to step out on faith.
Yes.
Be in your bubble of comfort.
Yes.
And bless us with your Holy Spirit, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for all who you continue to be and all who you will touch in our lives.
Yes.
Let us be a blessing.
Mm-hmm.
Let us be that aura that we can
mm-hmm.
pass off to other people.
Thank you.
And tell them about who you are, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for all that you will do.
Yes.
You know, we're not concerned about where we are right now, Lord, because we know we're in the best position that we could possibly be in.
Mm-hmm.
To be according to your will and your way, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We praise you on the day.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.